is that I don't know if the colonel has spoken about the radiation readings that were taken at the landing site. Well, the British government defence intelligence staff subsequently assessed those radiation readings as significantly higher than background levels. So there was a real tangible, solid piece of evidence to back up this extraordinary testimony.
Nick, does the British government take the same position as the United States government, as if to say it doesn't exist?
Well, the position is broadly similar, but having said that, the Ministry of Defence still does have a small UFO project, although investigations are somewhat on the back burner these days. But, you know, I think there are still cases being reported to the government. There are still, for example, many reports coming in from pilots, reports of UFOs being tracked on radar, and the Ministry of Defence says that it keeps an open mind about the UFO phenomenon.
Fife, what do you believe? Do you believe there is life somewhere else?
I would be astonished to find out, if it were possible, that we were alone in the universe. We're this wonderful planet in the Milky Way, surrounded by billions of objects, and the universe is such a big place. I just think that you have to be open to that possibility.
Isn't it also open to the possibility, James, that this is just phenomena?
Well, yeah, they're definitely phenomena, but I mean, I think the people in a position to know what's really going on are about to disclose that on November 12th at the National Press Club in Washington, D.C., and hopefully
people
will
listen. You say the government is going to disclose something?
The government officials from seven countries, military and government officials.
Will disclose on Monday?
Yes, they will.
Yeah, this is an unprecedented gathering of top officials.
Why now, Colonel Holt?
I think there's greater acceptance now that there really is something there, despite the fact that there's kind of a stigma that goes with UFOs.
You believe that too, Sergeant? They're ready to come across and say at least there's something?
I think it's unavoidable right now. I think that there's been so much cases and so many points made over the last 20 years. I think it's overwhelming.
Nick, you think the British government is ready?
Yes, I think so. I think part of the problem with all of this is the stigma that's sometimes attached simply to the word UFO. And some colleagues and I at the Ministry of Defence actually tried to do away with that term and replace it with unidentified aerial phenomena, because we were certainly convinced that there were some serious defence, national security and flight safety issues here, even though we didn't know what the UFO phenomenon actually was.
What did this do to your head, Jim?
Well, I tell you what, it's a very difficult situation, and it had a terrible effect on also the airmen that were out there with me. Some won't go on camera, some will not talk about today. I think that it would probably cause a lot of... I had problems with, you know, post-traumatic stress after it, that
sure.
type of thing.
Psyche.
Yeah, it was a very traumatic experience.
We've got lots more to go. Our complete program tonight is devoted to unidentified flying objects. We'll interrupt our panel. We've been talking with military officials about UFOs. Coming up, we'll ask Shirley MacLaine what she thinks about these reports. That's next on Larry King Live.
Did you see a UFO?
I did.
I don't really know what happened to it. I saw one, but I don't know what, it just disappeared.
It's time to find out what the truth really is that's out there.
That such an investigation be taken.
Came to you eventually, and the police officer too.
They're coming.
From a movie, Don't Take This as War of the Worlds. Don't go panicking out into the streets. She's an old and dear friend and one of the more talented people on the American scene. Shirley MacLaine, the Oscar-winning actress, author of a new book, Saging While Aging. All of her books are major bestsellers. There you see its cover. There's a lot in this book that we're not into tonight, but we're going to discuss one aspect of it, which is UFOs, fitting our subject tonight. By the way, Shirley came up during a recent Democratic presidential debate in Philadelphia. Tim Russert is asking Representative Kucinich about MacLaine's book. Watch. Oh, I'm sorry. I thought we had it. They lied to me again. Anyway, many people react with laughter when they hear people talk about UFOs. Mm. How do you explain that?
I don't know. I think the unknown is traumatizing to people. I think we do have a built-in DNA of fear. One of the reasons I'm so interested in all this, well, I'll tell you how I got interested in a minute if you want to know, but I think the consciousness of how we relate to this phenomenon and the consciousness of change that happened to people who were taken aboard crafts, because I've talked to a lot of them.
Like the sergeant said, he's never been
the
same.
He was afraid. The whole idea of what induces fear is something they talk about a lot. It's, to me, I don't want to get into arguments, are they real or not, anymore. I've had too much experience talking to people all over the world, particularly in Peru, who have satisfied me. But what...
So you believe in them.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I think maybe... the problem with accepting it and the need to have a kind of curtain of humiliation drawn is that it confounds us relating to our religion and our belief in God. But what I found with the people, and I worked a lot with Johnny Mack, head of psychiatry at Harvard, old friend of mine, wonderful man, and he said that we have to get clear in our own heads, in our own consciousness, what God is.
And do you think this sort of to people tells us there is no God because there's
the opposite there? The opposite, because what they've told me is they're being taught two things. They're being taught that we are trashing the planet in a fierce way. Be careful. And then we're being taught that they too, even though they may be extremely superior in many technological ways, they're trying to teach us about the superiority of our technical spirit and knowledge that we haven't even touched.
Why do you think, just think, they don't land in downtown Washington?
Well, listen, I was 18 years old, Arlington, Virginia, where we lived. UFOs buzzed the Capitol and buzzed the White House on July 19th, 1952. I recorded it in my diary. No one knew what it was. The switchboards lit up. Everybody was confused. A few days later, Truman, who was president then, had General Samford go on television. I have the kinescope, actually, and say, look, they're not ours and they're not Russian. We don't know what they are.
And you got the form there that Jimmy Carter filled out?
Yeah, I found the actual one where he's got all of his handwritten notes.
Well, he saw a sighting.
Oh, sure. Well, a lot
of people. The Vatican said something?
Yes. Now, this is interesting in relation to the question and problem of religion and God. Padre Balducci, wonderful man, Monsignor Balducci, very close to each pope. He has come out with a statement. You see how thick it is, so I can't read it. They're real. They have discussed what to do about it. Vatican intelligence would really like to discuss it. That's the problem here. We need the governments to reveal these files. The Chinese have done it. The Brazilians have done it. The French did it about a month ago, and it so lit up their switchboard, crashed their net. So I think the people are way ahead of military intelligence.
Well, what is the, since they're not attacking us and they've been seen for years, what's the fear? What's the government's fear?
That's an interesting question. I've been working with Paul Hellyer. He's the minister, ex-minister of Defense Canada under Trudeau. He is upset because the Americans are planning the weaponization of space as though they are enemies.
Really?
Yes. And it is very troubling to him. It came out of a project called Project Paperclip, in which, and this is what Eisenhower warned us against, the sustention of the military-industrial complex. In order to extend the power and the funding of the military-industrial complex, you have to be afraid of things. Number one was communism. If that petered out, number two is terrorism. That's here for a while. Number three is asteroids, and number four is extraterrestrials. So there might be a built-in reasoning here to have induced fear just to keep military-industrial complex
fighting. You've talked to a lot of people over the years, right? Yeah. Astronauts, presidents, etc. Yeah. And your belief is firm, right?
No question.
You think we'll ever...